Alright, welcome back to the channel, welcome back to another video. And we've got ourselves quite the topic today. And I just woke up about 5 minutes ago, I'm not even kidding. So there was this huge controversy surrounding this birthday party. It was like a private bowling party. And it was hosted by this streamer G Nelly, and there were a bunch of other UK content creators at the party. And it wasn't like this huge party, it was like a small private bowling party. And there were content creators there such as Wilbur, George Not Found, Jack Manifold, I'm Alex, Memeulous, and many more. And people were posting photos at the party, and that's how everyone found out. And once George Not Found and Wilbur were spotted at this party, it was over. Twitter absolutely lost their shit. They got very, very pissed. Which, when isn't Twitter mad? So, Wilbur negative and George Not Found negative both went trending once people found out that they were at this party. And this situation just continued to get worse. It doesn't stop there. And yeah, before we do jump into the video today, if you're new to the channel, consider subscribing. And yeah, without further ado, I'm just gonna jump right in. So basically, G Nelly hosted her 26th birthday party and Twitter just fucking exploded. So I found a slash negative for about every fucking Minecraft content creator that went there. And it says Jack Manifold negative, Nikki negative, Puffy negative, Minx negative, Wilbur Soot, George Not Found yet negative. You get the fucking point. I hope all these content creators at the party never get to see their American friends, smiley face, slash negative. Like, you didn't include enough fucking negatives already. Like, how many do you need? It looks like Morse code. Like, I can barely read the tweet. I can definitely tell by reading that tweet, their blood is boiling, whoever is behind the screen. And Wilbur went live after this party. I think it was like the morning after. And Twitter got even more pissed after Wilbur went live. And people on Twitter were mad because Wilbur didn't address anything with the party, and he had his mods ban words such as party and mask in his chat. So basically, anyone tweeting Wilbur negative or like getting mad at Wilbur right now is basically tweeting slash getting mad at a fucking brick wall. Like, Wilbur doesn't even go on Twitter, probably for reasons like this, and I don't blame him at all. So like I said earlier, G Nelly had to put out a statement about this whole situation, this whole party, and it says this right here. I genuinely never want to upset or harm people, and I'm sorry I've done that. Please know that everything at my party was within the UK government guidelines. We are fortunate enough that 80% of the UK is currently vaccinated. We are also very fortunate to be able to test daily here in the UK, with people attending completing a negative lateral flow test beforehand, and everyone will be testing after. It was a private small bowling alley of close friends with no public interaction to ensure we were safe as possible. Again, sorry for upsetting anyone. So from my understanding, everything at the party was within the UK government guidelines. They were all tested before the party, after the party, and they were all double vaccinated. Like, everyone there followed the rules. Everyone followed the guidelines. It was a small, private bowling party, and there was no public interaction whatsoever. So I really don't see an issue with this at all. The real issue of this situation is that there are actually sad, low-life losers that are sending Wilbur, George, and pretty much any of these creators death threats for attending a party. You know, I haven't seen any of the death threats myself. I haven't seen any, but there are people on Twitter saying that he did get death threats. I'll read this one tweet, for example. Yeah, but the thing is, people are taking it way too far, and it looks like they're trying to control these content creators just because they did something they don't agree with. Other people are sending death threats to them, and I'm Alex and Wilbur have bad anxiety. So of course, this situation just got worse, and it just went way further than it needed to be. Twitter has no idea what respectfully disagreeing is. Like, you can realistically think whatever you want about this situation, but it just goes way too far when you send somebody a death threat or attack somebody for going to a party. Death threats are never okay in any circumstance, and neither is doxing or any of that bullshit. I'm not too sure what happened, but people were saying that Wilbur got the worst of it. And I'm pretty sure he got the most hate sent his way. So here's what Memeulous tweeted. He tweeted this out right here. Twitter is so odd. People are only pretending to care about this as an excuse to abuse people. Like, if they actually cared about this, they'd be talking about clubs and festivals and not a small gathering at a bowling alley of people who are mostly double vaxxed. Hope you're okay. Yeah, I don't know why Twitter doesn't speak on gatherings that are are way worse than a small private bowling party that everyone got tested beforehand. But Memulus is right, Twitter is very odd. So I don't know how the guidelines are in the UK. If you live in the UK, and if you know, I mean, drop a comment. But I'm pretty sure there are no more restrictions in the UK. Don't quote me on it, obviously, I don't fucking live there. So Dream also made a response to this whole situation, and here is what he had to say. People need to not be gross. I've seen way too much horrible stuff about it all. But although I do agree people are blowing things out of proportion and being abusive and gross when they have no right to be, just correct potential misinformation. People with vaccinations have much more viral loads and can still spread the virus to other people that aren't vaccinated, and may be even more likely to. Even one person getting the virus / Delta variant will spread the virus to an average of 6 to 7 people who will then spread it to 6 to 7 people and so on. Quickly shooting up to thousands from one new case, and who knows, who could be in those thousands, elderly, etc. Alright, I'm just a fucking commentary channel. I'm not really going to comment too much about this whole viral load shit. I have no idea who carries more viral loads and this and that, but I'm glad he's calling people out for blowing this whole fucking thing out of proportion, because it really is. It really is being blown out of proportion. And then after, here's what he said. Inside, the virus spreads worse. Without a mask, the virus spreads worse, and the longer you are close to people, the virus spreads worse. If everyone was tested before and after, though, like G said, there's no problem with it, and it's a very responsible way of doing this with very little to no risk. People are making a much bigger deal out of it than it should be, though either way, and using it as an excuse to attack people. Don't want to see any of that gross stuff or see people support it. Then Keemstar made a video, you know, gave his take on this whole situation, and here's what he had to say.
People seeing Wilbur and the Minecraft stands lost their mind, saying that she was having a COVID party, that she's spreading COVID, all this stuff. They started sending her death threats, saying horrible stuff about suicide. I mean, some pretty dark stuff. She was getting a ton of hate. A bunch of the UK YouTubers came in and defended her. She had to come out with a statement. She said, hey, look, everybody was vaccinated. This was a private bowling alley that we rented. You know, we took all the precautions. Everything is being followed through the UK guidelines, because basically Dream's point was, okay, look, everybody's vaccinated, but you can still carry the virus and spread it to others. Well, to that I would say, life is a risk, all right?
I mean, he's not wrong. There's always going to be a little bit of risk in life, no matter what you do. Like, just by me putting myself out there on YouTube, I mean, that's a pretty big risk in itself right there. You know, I played sports as a kid. Although I sucked royal ass at baseball or whatever I played, I risked getting injured. Like, you can get injured when you play sports. My point being, there's risk in everything.
If you want to live so safe, right, and you don't think that, you know, anybody should go out and fucking do anything, keep that to yourself. Lock yourself up in the room, put duct tape on the fucking doors, and never live your life. But don't stop others from living their life. That's fucking insanity.
They did it the safest way possible by following all the guidelines and everything. They got tested before and after the party, and they were all vaccinated. They did it in a private setting. I really don't see the issue. But yeah, I think that's gonna do it for today's video. If you did enjoy it, like, subscribe, and turn on notifications if you don't want to miss an upload. And if you did make it this far into the video, comment, Twitter is garbage. But yeah, catch you all in the next video. I'm out. Peace.